Hello everyone, this is Sneha. Today in this video, I'm going to talk about the German physicist Wilhelm Edward Weber. Wilhelm Weber's major contribution was on magnetism and electricity. To start with his early life, he was born in the early 1800s. To be precise, he was born on 24th of October in 1804 in Wittenberg. He was son of Michael Weber, who was a professor of theology at the University of Wittenberg. On the top right corner, you see a picture, which is the picture of University of Wittenberg. Unfortunately, there was a war in 1815, and due to that war, the University of Wittenberg was completely collapsed. And later, their family had to move to a place called Halle, and his father started to work in the University of Halle. And after a few years, Wilhelm Weber joined the same university, and he specialized in natural philosophy, and he also got a PhD degree from the same university. And on the bottom right corner is the picture of the University of Halle. To talk about his career, I have to mention about his friend, well-wisher and colleague, who was Professor Gauss. They met in a conference, and because of their similar interest in geomagnetism, they got along very well. Due to this friendship and belief on Wilhelm Weber, Professor Gauss offered him a position in the University of Göttingen as physics professor. Later, they worked together and published many informative papers, and their first publication was on 1832. And following that, in 1833, they came up with Göttingen Magnetische Wellen, which was a project that aimed to measure the way in which the Earth's magnetic field fluctuates. And later, they designed the first long electromagnetic telegraph, which was about 9,000 feet long. The below is the picture of the electromagnetic telegraph that's given in the slide. And on the top right corner is the University of Göttingen, and right below that picture is the picture of Professor Gauss. The other major work of Wilhelm Weber was, in 1846, he developed an electrodynamometer in which a current causes a coil suspended within another coil to turn when a current is passed through both of these coils. And the right corner is a picture of the electrodynamometer. And followed by this work, in 1852, he defined the absolute unit of electrical resistance. And later, he designed a magnetometer along with Professor Gauss. This magnetometer was able to measure the magnetic strength. The attractive point about this magnetometer is that it was portable and it was very sensitive in measuring the magnetic field. Apart from working with Professor Gauss, he also worked with Professor Kohlrausch, who was a professor of University of Göttingen as well. Along with him, he found the ratio between the electrostatic and electrodynamic units of charge, and they published this work in 1856. This work was believed to be the basis of the expansion of the Maxwell's theory, which was related to the fact that the light is considered as an electromagnetic wave. Later, Weber worked with his own brother, who was Ernst Heinrich Weber. He wrote a book along with him named Wave Theory and Fluidity, in which they spoke about many rheological concepts. They spoke about the flow of liquids and water and sound waves. As an honor to Weber, to his contributions to science, they named the SI unit of magnetic flux after him as Weber, and they abbreviated it as WB. In person, he was a very friendly person. He was humble and simple. He was an inspiration to his students because of his amazing way of teaching. He always encouraged his students to think out of the box. He was never married, and because of this reason, all the responsibility in his house was taken care of by his sister, and after his sister, the responsibilities were taken over by his niece. He died at the age of 86 in his garden in the year 1891, and he was buried in the city cemetery of Göttingen. Thank you for listening, guys.